If your feet feel numb, tingly, or like they're on fire and you're tired of being told to just take more meds, this might be the breakthrough you've been looking for. Because here's the truth. Most people with peripheral neuropathy are never shown the right exercises to restore sensation, improve balance, and reduce nerve pain. And that's a big reason why their symptoms never improve. In this video, I'm going to show you three science-backed foot exercises that we use with patients at Asuta Health Neuropathy Centers designed to increase blood flow, stimulate nerve recovery, and help you trust your feet once again. And the last one, it's a powerful proprioception reset that you can do with your eyes closed. One that helps retrain your brain to reconnect with your feet. So make sure you watch till the end. Hi, I'm Dr. Ole Olson, America's neuropathy coach and founder of Asuta Health Neuropathy Centers. At Asuta Health, we help you heal peripheral neuropathy naturally so you can move, feel, and live better because you matter. If you have peripheral neuropathy in your feet, you know how frustrating it is to lose feeling, struggle with balance, or even deal with the constant nerve pain. And here's the truth. Most exercises people try don't target the real problem. They're either too general or they don't actually stimulate the nerves that need healing. That's why this matters. These aren't generic stretches. They're targeted movements that help reawaken nerve pathways, improve blood flow, and retrain your brain to connect with your feet again. And when that happens, you can start to feel your feet again when you walk, improve your balance, sleep better at night, and even walk longer distances without pain or fear of falling. Let's go ahead and get started. Exercise number one. The first exercise is the towel scrunch plus marble pickup combo. This exercise targets the small foot muscles that weaken when nerve signals are disrupted. For people with peripheral neuropathy, that means poor balance, unstable walking, and less control over their feet. By reactivating these muscles and stimulating nerve endings in the toes, this drill helps to restore strength, feeling, and coordination so your feet feel more connected and more stable when you move. To begin, you're gonna sit in a chair with both feet flat on the floor. Place a towel in front of you so it's just under your toes. Make sure you're barefoot. This won't work with socks on. Now here's what you're gonna do. Start curling your toes to grip the towel and pull it towards you. Try to gather as much of the towel as you can using just your toes. You'll feel those tiny foot muscles working, and that's the point. This helps improve muscle activation in areas where the nerves have gone quiet. Do this for 30 to 45 seconds on each foot. You can repeat this 2 to 3 rounds per session. Once you finish the towel scrunch, go ahead and move on to the second part of the drill, the marble pickup. Go ahead and place a few marbles, coins, or small objects on the floor. Using your toes, you're gonna pick up one at a time and drop them into a bowl or a cup. This challenges those fine motor skills, the control, the proprioception, and the brain's connection to the foot. It may feel difficult at first, but keep going. The more you do this, the more the nerves begin to wake up. Aim for about 10 to 15 pickups per foot once or twice a day. You can do this daily, even multiple times per day, especially if you're sitting a lot. As you stick with it, you may notice better grip, more control when you walk, and even a bit more sensation returning to your feet. That's progress. Don't rush it. Keep showing up and the results will build. Exercise two. The next exercise is the seated nerve glide for the peroneal and tibial nerves. Peripheral neuropathy doesn't just affect the skin or the muscles. It directly impacts how nerves move and glide throughout the body. When nerves get irritated or compressed, they become less mobile and their ability to send signals to the feet breaks down. That's where nerve glides come in. This seated nerve glide helps mobilize two major nerves in the lower leg, the peroneal and tibial nerves, which are often involved in foot numbness, tingling, and pain. By gently gliding the nerves instead of stretching them, we can reduce irritation, improve signaling, and support healing over time. To do this, start by sitting upright in a chair with both feet flat on the floor. Let's begin with your right leg. Extend it out in front of you so your heel is resting lightly on the ground. Keep your knee slightly bent and your foot relaxed. Now, lift your foot and toes up toward your shin. That's called dorsiflexion. At the same time, gently tilt your head back, looking slightly upward. Hold for a second or two. Then you're gonna slowly lower your foot, pointing your toes down while at the same time tucking your chin down toward your chest. That's one rep. You're moving your foot and your head together in opposite directions. This creates a gentle sliding or gliding motion of the nerve through the tissue without putting too much tension on it. It may feel strange at first, or you might even feel a light pull or a tingle. That's okay. Don't force it. Keep it comfortable. Do 10 slow, controlled reps per leg. Take your time. You can do this exercise 1 to 2 times per day, especially when symptoms feel worse or after sitting too long. As you repeat this over days and weeks, you may notice less nerve irritation, less burning, or zapping pain in the feet, and better control during walking. This is a key reset for nerve mobility and communication. Exercise 3. The next exercise is the heel to toe rocking with eyes closed. Peripheral neuropathy doesn't just affect sensation. It also impacts proprioception, your body's ability to sense where your feet are on the ground. That's a big reason why balance gets worse and the risk of falling increases. This next drill retrains your brain to use feedback from your muscles and joints instead of just relying only on your vision. By doing it with your eyes closed, you're focusing your nervous system to reconnect with your feet. Over time, this can help you feel more stable, more aware of your body and space, and less anxious when walking or standing. To do this, go ahead and start by standing tall with your feet about hip width apart. Make sure you're near a wall or a counter in case you need support. Now, take a deep breath and center yourself. Slowly shift your weight forward onto your toes. Don't lift your heels, just feel that pressure move forward. Then gently rock back onto your heels, lifting your toes just slightly off the ground. This is a slow, controlled rocking motion. Forward, then backward. Now close your eyes. Keep the motion going, but reduce the range a bit if you feel unstable. With your eyes closed, your brain has to rely on signals from your feet and your ankles instead of just your vision. This is where the real proprioceptive training happens. As you do this, you might feel a bit wobbly. That's okay. That's your nervous system working to rewire itself. Over time, this helps improve balance, awareness, and coordination. Continue this for about 60 seconds. Rest, then repeat for 2 to 3 rounds total. You can do this once a day, or even twice if balance is a major concern. What you can expect from this is more confidence when walking, better balance when standing still, and a greater sense of connection between your feet and your body. This may seem simple, but it has a powerful effect on how your brain processes movement and stability. You now have 3 powerful foot exercises that you can start using today. This set of exercises is designed to do 3 key things: help relieve nerve pain, improve your balance, and restore feeling and control in your feet. This means you're not stuck, you're not powerless. There are real, practical steps that you can take right now to feel more stable, more connected, and more hopeful about your recovery. So don't give up, keep going. Even small steps like these, done consistently, can lead to big changes over time, because you matter. Please like and share this video if you found it even a little bit helpful from these exercises. And leave a comment, tell me which one helped you the most. Subscribe if you want to finally get real answers, real support, and real hope for peripheral neuropathy. I'm building this channel to be the go-to place for peripheral neuropathy support right here on YouTube. And the next video you need to watch is top 5 supplements and vitamins to repair your nerves. If you want to support healing from the inside out, that video is a must-see.